Hello everyone, how are you today? This is Mark. I'm doing great. Thanks for asking. When did you start learning English? How many English books have you read so far? Who taught you English when you were at primary school? Do you know how people avoid making mistakes in English? In this lesson, I'm going to teach you how to make questions easily. So stay tuned. I've noticed that a lot of students have problems making questions in English. This lesson I want to dedicate to making questions and make it as easy as possible for you. So, when we ask for when or the object of a sentence, we use this kind of formula. So, we have the WH question word, which is when, how, were, what, etc. Then we need the auxiliary. An auxiliary could be do, does, did, be, have, will, can, could, etc. Then the subject, that it could be a pronoun or a noun. Then we have the verb. It could be a present participle or a past participle or the base of the verb. Then we need the object, maybe, sometimes, okay? If we ask for when, we need the object. If we ask for the object, obviously we don't write the object in the question. So, the object, sometimes, and then the time expressions, or the time expression, if we ask for the object. So, the time expression could be yesterday, today, last week, last month, etc. So I'm going to give you an example of this. So, when did you start learning English? When did you start learning English? Look at the auxiliary. The auxiliary is the blue color. Did you start? The start is the base of the verb, so it's the verb. Learning, okay, start learning. English, which is the object, okay? Here we asked for when, so that's why we need the object. Now, in this case, we are asking for the object. So, what is she doing now? In this case, we have the verb to be, so is as an auxiliary. She is the object, is a pronoun. Then doing is the verb, the main verb, so is the present participle. And then now, which is the time expression at the end. So what is she doing now? Then we can have a yes or no question. So we don't need the WH question word at the beginning. So what we need is the auxiliary. So the auxiliary in this case is do. Do you is the subject. Do you like eating is the verb. Do you like eating pizza? Okay, so eating belongs to like. What do you like eating? Do you like eating pizza? So pizza is the object in this case. So this is for or when we ask for the object or when. What happens if we have or if we ask for the subject of the sentence. So the formula changes here. We need who or what at the beginning, then we need the auxiliary sometimes, and I will explain why sometimes, then we need the verb, and in this case we need to conjugate the verb, then we need the object, and then we need the time expression sometimes. So, we do not use do, does, or did in these type of questions when we ask for a subject. Let me explain by giving an example. For example, who taught taught you English when you were in primary school was the question. Who taught you English? In this case, we have who is the WH question word. Then we have taught, which is the past participle of the verb to teach and is a past simple question. Who taught you? You is the object. English is the object. So who taught you English? Tina is the answer who. Tina is the subject. Taught me English when I was in primary school. So as you can see, we do not use the auxiliary did in a subject question. Let me give you another example with the auxiliary. Who is going to cook tomorrow? In this case, we ask for the person, for the subject, but we need the auxiliary to be. Who is going to cook tomorrow? So, for example, John or Peter or he is going to cook tomorrow. As you can see, we need the auxiliary. So in this case, we need the auxiliary because it's not do, does, or did. Now, I'm going to give you another example of other types of questions. Now, if you want to ask for more information about the object of the statement, we use how much and how many, plus noun. If you want to review these two, you may click here. Now, I'm going to tell you more or less what they are used for. How much is used for uncountable nouns? What do I mean? I mean singular nouns, for example, water or flower or anything that you cannot count, okay? Or coffee. They are just uncountable nouns. Meat. How many? How many is with countable nouns? So for example, apples, oranges, anything that is plural, that it can become plural. So let me give you an example. How much water do you drink a day? How much water do you drink a day? Obviously, I'm asking for more information about the object. So water would be the object here. So how much water do you drink a day? I drink 3 liters of water. Okay. So, for example, with how many? How many English books? In this case, we have English books. So, is a countable noun. How many English books have you read so far? I have read 50 English books so far. One last thing that I want to mention about questions. Indirect questions. These are more formal and thus more polite. So we use, could you tell me? Do you know? Do you have any idea? Would it be possible? Is there any chance? Remember though that this is a question, but the next part of the statement is a positive one. Let's look at my examples. Do you know how people avoid making mistakes in English? So you can see, do you know is the question. How people avoid making mistakes in English is a positive statement. We don't make a question here. Many students make a question even here. No, is incorrect. Let's look at the second example. Could you tell me when the train arrives? Okay, could you tell me is the question and the positive statement when the train arrives? Let's look at a conditional sentence or question. Would it be possible? Would it be possible if I called you tomorrow? This is the second conditional. In this case, it's a question. Would it be possible if I called you tomorrow? So it's not a question here, is a positive statement. The only question is, would it be possible? So now, let's recap. In this lesson, we looked at how to make questions in an easy way. There are object, subject, and indirect type of questions. Object questions ask for the object of the statement. Subject questions ask for the subject of the statement, obviously. And indirect questions are a more polite way to put a question. I've also mentioned how much and how many, plus a noun, just to ask for more information about the object. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. If you have comments, requests, or if you want to type your own question under this video, you may do so. Don't forget to share it. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so, so that the following week you get another new lesson. Have a great day, and I see you next week. Take care. Bye-bye.